double team. Reyes, the pass to Randle. Here's lights out, defended by Gordon. No good from Reyes.
Well, it looks like he's cooled down a bit after hitting those two in the first quarter.
And Fournier kicks to Fultz. The Magic getting another chance here. Just five to shoot. He gets it in there. Fultz has got six in the quarter.
Boy, Fultz so good at getting to his spots and then capitalizing, Kevin. I like watching this guy score the ball.
Reyes. Here's Robinson. And the rebound paying off as if he got two on the 70-chance bucket right there.
Excellent activity and timing on the offensive glass. That's how you get extra possession.
And it's Fultz with the ball for the Magic.
And that's his fourth foul. And we're not even at halftime. That is going to limit his playing time and his aggressiveness the rest of the game.
And he can't get the first one. Third quarter action getting rolling right now. Brought to you by Gatorade. All fueled up and ready to go. Here's who's on the floor. So on the floor for Orlando. At the four and the five, we have Gordon and Vucevic. Fultz is out there with Evan Fournier, and it's Isaac into the small four. And the call will be against Fournier. That's his third foul of the game. And a minute played as the second half gets going.
You know, the long arms of Vucevic is annoying to shooters, and he's putting his giant frame to good use.
Fournier goes in for Barrett. Fournier's shot is off.
And the well is running dry for him right now. Nothing falling.
And, you know, you can sense his frustration. This is going to be a test of his resolve here.
And goaltending is going to be the call. So they get the basket there anyway.
Yeah, that's a tough call for the refs to make there. I'm not sure it was on the way down, but that's how they saw it.
They've been looking out of sync offensively.
Yeah, their offense has ground to a standstill.
Now, here's Isaac. Defense is right there.
Well, you know, he's still listed at 6'10", but when you see him standing next to teammates, guys, Jonathan Isaac is clearly taller. By the time he's done growing, he's projected to be a 7-footer or north of that.
The second from the line. And Isaac doesn't want that 7-footer lead. Something we've seen before with the guys like Garnett and Kevin Durant.
Yeah, I agree. There are a couple of things that go into that when you talk about guys not wanting to be listed at 7 feet. He grew up playing on the perimeter and still has an attachment to that part of his game. And I think there's also the feeling if you're listed at 7 feet, you're going to get stuck inside. But even more than that, folks tend to look at you differently when you're a 7-footer. Because you appear to be out of the norm in a major way.
And keeping us updated from the sideline, let's swing it over to David Aldridge.
Well, we all know that circumstances and time changes everything. In Dallas, Dennis Smith Jr. thought he was going to be the cornerstone. But with the arrival of Luka Doncic, everything changed. A promising point guard was traded to the Knicks. And Smith said it was important. Big opportunity, and I've just got to make the most of it. Kevin, we know one thing. In New York, the ball is back in Smith's hands.
And D.A., that's when he is at his best. Thank you. And slam dunk by Vucevic.
And, you know, one of the best parts of Nikola Vucevic's game is his great body, excellent hands, and the high motor makes him an outstanding rebound.
Robinson misses.
And that is a textbook example of how to defend your rim.
I love his fight and grit on the interior. I mean, he never lets a shot go uncontested.
Good work there as it goes.
Sometimes, quite simply, getting a hand in the face of Vucevic is not enough. He doesn't buckle when the defense tightens up.
Fultz brings the double team. Randle. Oh, and he plucks it off the glass. Wow. Fouled on the shot and picks up 2 points. So one free throw coming up. That'll put Mitchell Robinson on the one. It's going to be on Aaron Gordon. The Knicks have made a little more than half their free throws today, 7-12. That one misses for Robinson.
Our
Mark, you were so good at such an early age in your basketball career. At what point did you personally realize just how far the game could take you?
You know, it really resonated with me, Kevin, I think at a summer basketball camp at Miami of Ohio when some of the better campers, high school campers, were asked to play with the college guys at night. And then during pickup games in my hometown of Cleveland with some of the Cleveland Cavaliers, Jim Jones and the late Terry Furlow and Mike Mitchell, and being able to compete somewhat with those guys at 15 and 16 years of age and having them encourage me to keep going, and then I have a chance to do what they were doing at the time, which was play pro ball.
Currently here in the game, you can look at this performance as a direct indicator of why they're losing.
Reyes, the pass to Robinson. Here's lights out, launches it. Gets hauled in by Gordon. Gordon's got 6 rebounds in the game. Side Fournier. There's the dish to Vucevic. Over Barrett. And it's Vucevic missing. The Knicks leading by 20. Inside, here's Robinson. Shooting foul as the whistle blows. He'll shoot 2 free throws. That one on Vucevic.
I'll tell you what, he earned his money on that foul.
Yeah, if you're going to foul, then make sure that you don't give a chance for the and one.
Frank Ntilikina is checked in for Maurice Harkins. And a switcher also for Orlando. Mamba's checked in. And no good. Excellent D that time from Robinson.
Plus 8 in the rebound differential. One more reason why they're in control.
Yeah, double-digit advantage on the scoreboard. They've taken the initiative. They've played, I think, with more purpose so far.
Now, here's Fultz. 17 points in the game. Here's Fournier. And contact on the shot, so he'll be shooting free throws here.
Out of France, the sharp shooting Fournier, an important player to this team because of his scoring ability.
Hey guys, let's get your take on the hustle stats for the Knicks.
I thought we might see the defense adjust at halftime to slow the break, but that has not been the case.
Another part of their game that's made a difference tonight is all the second chance points they've been able to get.
And so Fournier nails both of them. Here's lights out. He's got 36. And the left side. The shot from the low post is good. Randall's got 9.
Well, he's a wrecking ball on offense. Randall, so good at finishing inside.
And here's Fultz. Outside Fournier. With the teardrop, the basket good off the assist from Fultz. Fultz has got 3 assists tonight.
Boy, that was a sweet-looking teardrop. There's very little defense for that.
New York leading by 21. Reyes, rebound by the Magic.
Yeah, and he had the D tangled up there with that patented crossover. Just couldn't convert the finish.
No one near Fultz as he lets it go. Hands the shot with nobody near him. Fultz has got 19 points.
Yeah, and you know, it's important that Fultz continue to develop his in-between game because he knows when to pull up.
Well, you and I are amazed at how the global interest of the NBA has just gone through the roof, or the league has made a lot of right moves, I think, in this era.
They sure have, Kevin. I couldn't agree with you more. I mean, the international reach through what coaches in this country have done in teaching the game and promoting the game, not just coaches, but players as well. I think there's something about the game of basketball that just really transcends cultures, the pace of the game, the personality of the players, the creativity of the game. All of that lends itself to being so popular globally.
The Magic making a switch here. Ross is checked in. Good ball movement here by the Magic. Over in the corner, Fultz. It's going by Barrett. 3-on-3. And foul on the shot, so he'll get a chance at the line. That's on Evan Fournier.
And at 6'7", Barrett with terrific positional size, which allows him to create problems for defenders down low.
That free throw, no good. And Greg, talking to scouts about R.J. Barrett, they love the athleticism. But what makes him especially good is the work ethic and the confidence.
Yeah, some elite prospects will take plays off. This guy never does. He's not one that sits around and reads his press clippings. He's a warrior, a leader, and he's proven to be a winner.
And he's good on the second. And for a lot of these kids, Greg, it's interesting how quickly teams expect them to get up to speed. Case in point. Taj Gibson's checked in for Robinson. Damian Dotson comes in for Barrett. And lights out sub in for Ntilikina. And a switcher also for Orlando. DJ Augustine's checked in for Fultz.
But it's important that Bamba stays healthy so he can keep improving. I mean, his skill set and physical tools both are very impressive. His upside is way up.
For the three. No good from Reyes.
Boy, this is bad. Tough to watch. I mean, this is really bad. He's stone cold this quarter.
No good from Ross.
Well, I cannot believe he didn't capitalize there. And neither can he. aggressive and calm.
He's made two of his last five attempts so far at the line. Good Vucevic check in for Orlando. And he sinks the second. New York leading by 18. A minute 50 left to play in the third. Here's Thompson. No points in the game hit for him. Mike at six. Puts up a three. No good from Reyes. The Magic trail by 18. Ennis with the ball. Guarded by Murray. Ennis kicks to Ross. Pass to Vucevic. Fades. It's rebounded by Reyes. Lights out. Got his sixth rebound on the night. Thompson in the corner. From outside the arc. No good from Reyes.
He has been ice cold from beyond the arc here since halftime, and he continues yet to fire away. He has got to tone it down if he wants to help his team. Well, we've seen that movie a few times, haven't we? An easy bucket in the paint.
Well, listless and lifeless at the defensive end. I mean, especially inside. They've really got to pick up that interior defense.
Just a quick look now at how the point totals have looked over the last few months for him.
And he's been on the upswing offensively these past few months. And you know how much they love getting all those extra points out of him. He's been carrying a much bigger load lately, and I think he'll just continue to get better.
He misses the free throw.
You know, it's been a bad day for them at the line today as a whole, and far too often, that's the case for this team.
A different look for New York. Harkless is checked in for Gibson, and Smith subbed in for Murray. Good on the second free throw. 50 seconds left to play here in the third. Augustine, looking at his point production, he averages almost 11 points a game. In the corner, Smith with it. Here's Reyes. It's good, the assist that time from Smith. Lights out, Scott, 48.
It's just hard to believe that someone can perform at such a high level. They've got to thank him for this one. Yeah, that's number five. One more, and he is going to be done for the day.
Hard to believe that DJ Augustine has been in the league over 10 years now, and he's carved out a nice place in the NBA. He's a calming presence with younger players and always consistently productive.
29 seconds left in the third. Here's lights out. Non-stop scoring machine here. Smith against Augustine. In the post, battles through traffic and lays it in. And the Knicks lead by 19.
Smith showing outstanding concentration on these hard shots, even as he's getting hit.
Augustine from outside, but they'll get another chance. Vucevic off target. And so it's New York taking a 19-point lead into the break. Their defense has been active and effective. We'll return shortly. It's time to bring up a State Farm assist of the game.
And the winner today, the big fella here with the sweetest of dimes. What a plus it is to have a post player who's got this ability to find.
Boy, that's a nice asset to have. It's a huge boost to any offense too, Greg. It adds a whole nother dimension when you've got a big guy that can match.
And we reach the fourth quarter in a game that may be already out of hand. Here's Augustine bringing it up now for Orlando. Trailing by 19. Harkless is out there with Bobby Portis. Then it's Dennis Smith. Then there's lights out.
Well, that's just strength there. That's what we call weight room. The power of Vucevic on display.
He Here's Reyes. And there goes incredible.
My goodness. 50 for the A's.
Yep, he is putting on a show. Augustine looking around. It's tipped.
See if that's the answer.
Here's Ross. Finds the bottom of the bucket from 13 feet out.
Oh, the speed of T. Ross.
For the Magic. Jonathan Isaac comes in for Bamba. And Evan Fournier subbed in for Ennis. And the call will be against Fournier. That's his fifth foul. The Knicks making a switch here. Robinson's checked in. Fultz, he's checked in for the Magic. We play just over 1 minute here in the fourth quarter. With the steal. Fultz looking around. It doesn't go for him. Some solid defense from Robinson. Randle passes to Barrett, and the whistle blows. It's going to be on Markel Fultz. That's foul number two for him. Dishes to Barrett. Up top, Harkless. And he gets the whistle. Two free throws coming up. First free throw is good. He makes one of two that time. The Magic trail by 18. To the paint. And Fultz gets it to go. Fultz has got 21 in the game.
And you know, Fultz is highly skilled as an offensive player. When he gets this kind of position inside, it's a wrap.
It's stolen by Fultz. And now Orlando on the break. Fultz with the ball. That one goes. Count it. Fultz has got 10 points in just the second half.
Every team looking to get easy ones in transition.
I think one of the best ways, guys, to score in transition is that quick hitter after the first burst.
To the middle, here's Harkless. Oh, and the jam by Harkless.
It really does make the game easy for your teammates when you can lead them to the rim that well with the pass.
Just under 2.5 minutes gone here in the final quarter. Fournier in the corner. Bangs home the trifecta.
Wow, has he flipped the switch at halftime. Much more effective here than the second half.
Randle left side. Reyes, the pass to Robinson. Great D that time from Vucevic.
And not allowing the shooter even an inch of breathing room on that one.
And guys, that's exactly the kind of high-impact defense they want to see out of him.
The shot's good from Fournier.
Really like the quick decision-making of Fultz there, Kevin. Excellent at surveying the floor for the open teammate.
Reyes, the pass to Robinson. Good from Reyes.
And maybe, you know, he thinks he can shoot himself out of the cold spell, but I don't think that's the case. Maybe somebody wanted to ease up off the three.
The Knicks leading by 11. Trying to get over his Randle. The shot's good from Reyes. Lights out, he's got 52 points.
He's certainly been their go-to guy when it matters most. He's trying to close this one out.
Fournier against Randle. Fournier gets to Isaac. Six on the shot clock. Here's Fultz. Off target from outside. The Knicks have gone 3-6 in the field so far in the fourth quarter. Here's Reyes. Here's Randle. Laid in with a nice touch off the glass. And the Knicks lead by 15.
You know, guys, Randle is simply a beast on the offensive board.
With the ball. Outside Fournier. Now here's Vucevic. Unloads from 13. That one wide left. To the paint. And Randle throws it down.
You know, once he has the positioning he wants, he's ready for the big finish. Julius Randle throwing it down.
He Here's Fultz. It's deflected. Inside. And Randle throws it down.
Yeah, letting it rip. They're just having fun right now.
Yeah, offensively, they've just been rolling. Impossible to stop.
Time call here. The Magic decide to talk it over.
And the lack of rim protection.
Knocks it loose. Lonzo looks like the Magic will retain possession here.
Risky pass there. They're lucky to retain possession this time.
Vucevic finds Isaac. Here's Fultz. And finished off by Fultz.
Man, I appreciate how skilled Fultz is handling the ball. I mean, excellent. They get into his favorite spots on the floor.
Now the pass to Randle. Here's lights out. Shoots the three. Vucevic with the rebound.
Well, most games he can knock it down from deep, but it just isn't there for him in this one.
Now, here's Isaac. He's covered by Reyes. Isaac misses.
Just a solid performance on the interior. The rebounding has been off the charts.
Yeah, you look across the board, it's actually sizing up, shaping up to be a great game. Strong performances throughout, and they've really been strong on the glass.
Down low, here's Fultz. Nails the baby hook. Fultz has got 14 points now in the second half.
You know, so far he's been dominant this period, making the most of his opportunity.
No good from Reyes.
You know, you don't always get that opportunity, so those are the ones you hate to miss.
Fournier in the corner. The basket good off the assist from Fultz. Fultz has got 5 assists tonight.
And hey, Fournier is not just an outside shooter. I mean, he can also get busy near the basket thanks to that quick release.
There's the feed to Vucevic. And slam dunk by Vucevic. That gives him the double-double. 10 points and 12 rebounds.
That's a double whammy, guys.
That's right. A great defensive play. Then the emphatic dunk.
Turning defense to offense, we talk about it all the time. Try to hit your opponent at the other end before they can set up the defense.
Both free throws, good from Reyes.
He's as solid as it gets from the line. I mean, give him the opportunity, he's cashing in on those.
It's Fournier on the wing, over Barrett, and it's Orlando with another.
Fantastic ball movement. They're picking them apart with their passing.
Purposeful passing it is, partner. Their last 10 points have all come off assists.
Pretty early to be over the limit. That foul situation is something we want to keep an eye on.
Shooting from the corner. Reyes. At the line for two. Good from Reyes. Both free throws good from Reyes. And here's Fournier. He brings it up with the Magic. 15-point game. Lays it up off the glass. Fournier's got 11 here in this quarter alone.
Defense looking helpless here. Fournier is solid as going despite getting hit. Really strong playing for contact.
The Magic trail by 15. Pulls up on the elbow, and again it's Orlando converting.
And after an abysmal first half from the field, the shots now starting to fall.
New York's gotten off to an 0-for-2 start from downtown here in the fourth quarter. Randle against Gordon. 6 to shoot. Randle passes to Harkins. Good! And the Knicks lead by 15.
And we always talk about making your teammates better. That assist was right on target.
off on the first.
Born in Toronto, Barrett joins a talented group of Canadians who have entered the NBA ranks.
And the second free throw, good. And here's Fournier. That shot, no good. Some solid defense from Robinson. Takes the assist and lays it in. Pick out the pass nicely. Harkless has got 11 points here in just the second half. Here's Fournier. Count it, good.
That makes it 10 of their last 12 coming from inside the paint.
Here's Reyes. And it's Orlando with the rebound. Vucevic has got 13 rebounds in the game. Seeded. Not wasting any time and taking the shot and knocking it down.
And they're showing much more focus here in the second half. More effort as well. And their offense starting to show signs of life.
Time call here. The Knicks decide to talk it over.
And he could tell his guys were dragging a little bit, calling time. And what an amazing ball game we've seen from him. It's been a one-man show worth the price of admission all by itself. There wasn't anything he couldn't do on that court tonight.
He sure has given this crowd a treat tonight. This kind of performance only cements his status as a fan favorite.
You know, it hasn't been his best outing, but they still find themselves in the driver's seat here.
And the shot goes in from Fultz.
And really, the scoring this quarter has been just off the charts, doing all he can to bring them back.
Randall got it, and he's now 8-9 from the floor.
Randall, another bucket. Continues to expand his offensive game.
Fultz, the pass to Vucevic. Robinson with the block.